Hello everyone. In this video, I'll show how to add undo, redo, and refresh button to this dashboard project. If you don't know how to use this dashboard, please check my previous video, or you can check link that I put in description this video. Here I have three SVG icon, now copy to the project. Then go to main form class to add these button. Here we have method create header, and we already have one menu button here, so now we need add three more button. We can copy from the menu button here. And copy this code to initialize these button. Then change the icon name to the icon that we have copied. So next we add these button to the panel. Now we can run the project. Here we see the button that we have add. So next we going to create the undo redo form action to these button. Here let check my old project that I have upload, how to create undo redo form, I will use some code from this video. And this code I have public on my GitHub, so now copy this class to the project. So next go to class form manager. Create the object undoRedo here. And we store the simple form class, so the form that we use in this dashboard must be subclass of the simple form. The simple form I have created in the package component here. So we need create method that we will use. Method form init and open, this method will execute only one time at the first when the form has display. Method form open, this method will execute all the time when form have display, like when we undo or redo. Method form refresh, this method will execute when we press the refresh button. And the last one is method form close. This method will execute when the form has exit to another form, and this method we set return true by default. So next go back to class form manager. Here create the public static method to use the undo redo form. We use the condition is the menu drawer do not showing, and check is undo able. After show the form, we call current form method as form open. We can copy it for the redo method. And one more method for refresh. And we need create method update temp form UI. We use this method when we change the theme's dark and light mode, it will update to UI form that store in the undo redo class. So we need call this method when we change the themes. Go to menu package and in class themes change. And we call this method here. So in the method show form, we need add the form to the form undo redo. Then back to main form, we need create event to these button. Now we can run it. But we need to disable the button while we cannot undo or redo form. Create method to disable and enable the button. We need get the form undo redo object, so go to form manager, and create method to get the form object. So go back to method check button. And we check the button when we set the form. Here now the button disable, and it will enable when we can undo the form. Then next we going to override the method, like form refresh or form open that we have add in simple form class. Here for form refresh. So I will test it's by just call chart component to start the animation, but it just for testing. Now the form refresh method is working. So in show form method here, we need call current form method, as form init and open. Go in dashboard form we test override this method. And we can override the method form open. Here we can see on the console output. and one more method as form close. By default this method returned true, but now I need return false, so if it returned false, this form cannot allow to close or exit this form. But it's still able to exit the dashboard form, because we not yet implement to check the method close form. Go to Form Manager to create method to check the form is can be close or exit. So when we call the form close method here, the method form close that we override will execute from this method, so if it return true, we able to display the next form. Here when undo or redo, we will check with this method. And when we show the form, we also need check with this method. So now we can run it. Now we cannot open another form. So we can test the output here, to sure this method has execute. So now I will show the sample how to use this method. Now for example, before this dashboard has close, I want to create the message confirm to the user to exit the form.